Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to thank all the organizers and Zeiss for having me here. Am I audible and is my screen visible, Dr.
Very
Kundu?
well, very well, ma'am. Very well.
So I would be talking on the management of astigmatism and the choice of toric lens, which is 80 Torby for the monofocal and 80 Lisa tritoric for the trifocal lens. So first of all, why do we need to do all this? Today's expected standards in cataract outcomes from the patient's point of view is they want uncorrected visual acuity, excellent visual quality, which is restored immediately with minimal or no spectacle dependence. And we can only achieve this by getting reliable refractive outcomes and astigmatism correction. The reason being that up to 70% of our cataract patients have some amount of astigmatism which needs to be looked into. And post-operatively, if this is not addressed, then at least 40% have it remaining, only 60% achieve less than 0.5 diopter. If the vision is 20/20, we can be very sure that the astigmatism was less than 0.5. The moment it goes to 0.5, the vision is not absolutely optimal that we would like. And this is a very, very gross idea of what the vision is like if there is even some amount of astigmatism which is left behind. And this is where we have patients who are not so happy. The various options that we have would be the limbal relaxing incisions manual or the femtosecond arcuate incisions, planning the incision on the steep axis, and toric IOLs, out of which toric IOLs are the most reliable ways in which we can look after astigmatism in a patient of cataract. So for this, we need to have proper armamentarium to work up our patients with the form of good keratometers, optical biometers, and of course, a topographer. Even in the basic examination, we have to see to it that we don't miss out on anything which gives us a suboptimal result. This becomes very, very important when we are planning a trifocal lens where the visual quality which the patient expects is exceptional. And the cases where we would not do it are mentioned here. We all know about them, but especially keratoconus irregular astigmatism, we would not wish to do a trifocal lens. This is absolute basic, but I still felt I should mention that we see that the patient is off contact lens. We take a measurement after a natural blink. Measurements are done on a day when there is no digital tonometry, etc. being done, or we don't touch the cornea for a pachymetry or anything. Even if we have other topographers use, we don't use those Ks. And our IA constants need to be optimized regularly. Even the axial length, we need to see that we have a good number of consistent measurements. Adequate signal reflex ratio should be achieved. And we remeasure if we find that there are some outliers or where we find that the data that we are getting is not consistent. And we need to reconfirm what we are doing before we proceed. Keratometry is rechecked in very flat, very steep corneas. Also, if both the eyes are not matching, and if it correlates poorly with whatever the patient is already wearing. So this has already been talked about, but I think that we cannot keep on not highlighting the use of this beautiful machine, especially from the point of view of having a swept source OCT giving us the posterior cornea data, which even in my journey in Contura, I've seen that it is just not the anterior cornea, which is important. It's the posterior cornea too. And we need to remember we are going to leave it behind. It's going to be in the eye. And that is what we need to factor, which the IOLMaster 700 helps us to do so beautifully. Because if we take data from other devices, they are not been tried and tested with the trusted formulas and constants. So it's much better that we have the data from the IOLMaster 700. And it is such robust, good data that we have, so reliable, so reproducible, and so easy to get it from the machine. And when put into our calculators, etc., it gives us such reliable data. And by doing this, we are replacing the posterior surface model with the actual posterior corneal measurement. And having an online calculator like the ZCAL, the Zeiss calculator, it gives us fantastic outcome prediction. It gives me the option of comparing both the eyes, and I can put in the total keratometry or the TK value directly and get an optimal lens power, which is decided by this particular calculator. Now we have done our tests, we've done our calculations, but it's very important that there is a precise alignment, a precise lens, which gives us a long-term stability in the surgical result that we achieve. That is possible with an image-guided system. So the difference is in getting a quantitative and a qualitative outcome. We have more satisfied patients because we've been able to do our job more thoroughly, and it gives an excellent outcome when we use an image-guided system to help us with the journey. So this is just an example of how this would really help us. We have the image of the eye where we can put in the data and analyze it. Head alignment and axis changing is something we are all aware of. And because here we have a reference image which gets re-registered in the operation theater, the head tilt, etc., does not change the result outcome that we have. We are all aware that a 15 degree and a 5 degree clockwise head tilt would result in a 12 degree or a 5 degree change in the clockwise rotation, and similarly in the anti-clockwise rotation, and that is why this becomes important. Also, it gives us an idea, the way our ZCAL does also, how the residual cylinder changes with incision location. If the surgeon wishes to do that, we can adjust that and decide prior to surgery what we want to do. Here, I just wanted to show a case which we had recently where it showed a lens which was T5, axis of placement 126, and on the image guided system, it showed a T3 with 20. I have picked this up at random just to show the importance of an image guided system. And when we saw this huge difference and went back and checked the data, the technician had forgotten the point decimal and put the SIA as 3 instead of 0.3. So this acted by corroborating the data which was there in the online calculator, even though it had been checked, but this saved us from creating a havoc result. So the monofocal lens that we have here, the 80 Torby, is bitoric with toricity on the anterior and the posterior surface. And this increases the effective optic size for the higher diopters, with the phenomenal diopter range of lenses available, which makes life much simpler with excellent image quality. With 91% of the patients up to 4.5 diopter correction showing less than 0.5 residual cylinder, and for the higher ones up to 84%, which is an excellent result to get. Also in myopes, where the bag is big, the assessment for the rotational stability at 6 months after implantation in action lengths greater than 25 and less than 27 has been shown to be excellent. I do a couple of things in these cases. One is I see to it that I put a CTR ring in patients who are high myopes. I don't leave it without a CTR ring, giving the lens an opportunity to rotate. And where needed, where I find there is some amount of jiggle, I do use an air tamponade also, and touch wood, so far I have not seen rotation. Now we come to the trifocal toric lenses, which is a challenge because these are the patients whose expectations are high and we have to be bang on with our results. There is no scope of error. We look at any pre-existing corneal astigmatism, which is 0.75 and above, and even 0.5 if the flat axis is such that it would increase. And we take a call as to which lens to select as per the calculations which proceed. This is a beautiful lens with a 360 degree anti-PCO barrier, add power for reading as 3.33 and for intermediate 1.66 with an excellent injector as been demonstrated earlier. and it has a 4-point haptic design, and it's available in 0.5 cylinder adapter steps with a huge range. And in the workflow, it can be rotated in both the directions, which is an advantage. SMP technology gives no light loss, no light reflexes, very little scattering, and no refraction errors created. Now, this is a screen which shows us the effect of astigmatism. So these are the spots focused by the multifocal lens. This is what happens in the case of astigmatism. And when we can correct that astigmatism, we again get nice point sources of light where the intensity is only decreased by 20%, which is a very, very good lens to use. This has already been discussed. We have an excellent defocus curve, and we have good near, intermediate, and far vision distribution. What we need to take care of in the theater, these are just a few points that I stress on, is the Rexis size, which should cover the optic all around. Aligning the lens a few degrees away till the viscoelastic is removed from below the lens completely, and the polishing, whatever has to be done is done. And then the alignment is done along with the rotation of the lens. Concentrating on the parallax, which is proximal in case a imaging system is not being used. Tapping the lens in the center at the air, sealing the chamber very tight because most of the rotations are in the immediate postoperative field. So not everyone wishes to give this importance, but we need to remember for every 3 degrees of axis rotation, 10% of the cylinder power is lost. And if we are above 30 degrees of rotation, we would be inducing a cylinder, and we need to be cautious of that. The contraindications are preoperatively, as said before, intra-op is PC rupture, zonular damage, and also if there is no 360 degrees overlap. This is possible, this type of technology is possible because we are concentrating on the biometry, the analysis, planning the surgery, marking well, taking care of cyclorotation, factoring the SIA, having our Rexis marker, positioning the lens, and in the end, analyzing our post-op results so that we can only become better. We need to take care of all the variables. They may be very small at each level, but if all are added, there is a lot of opportunity for error. The technology of the image managing system and the IL-Master 700 has allowed us to take our results to an excellent level in the last few years. So to summarize, managing astigmatism leads to better surgical outcomes in premium IOLs. The innovative Zeiss designs give excellent results. Patient satisfaction with premium IOLs increasing due to better technologies, better lenses that we have, and excellent results. Thank you.